How many people in this room feel that the person right next to you has 100% the exact same ethics as you? Please raise your hand. We do not want a world where any company or any country has produced the average ethics in a blender that we try to fine-tune. The entire concept of a monolithic approach to artificial intelligence is the exact wrong approach. What you need is intelligence at the edge. Your agent, your data, your ethics. If you make an AI system that only learns from the past, which is every AI system we're talking about today, they make mistakes because what isn't in the training data, it can't extrapolate. If we trained it on data 200 years ago, it would think slavery was a good idea. But today we're looking at AI systems by the world's leaders in the space who are making AIs that don't adapt, that are monolithic data systems that are trying to basically produce the average ethics in a blender. We don't have adaptation in these systems, which, by the way, that's what intelligence is. If you can't adapt to a new situation, you're not intelligent in that situation. So your old intelligence doesn't apply. What we're developing at Versus, based on cognitive architectures of how the mind works, how biological intelligence works, enables agents to adapt. Our main focus is not to try to artificially engineer intelligence in a computer, but rather to take the best of what we understand about biology, physics, and neuroscience and apply that to computing. And so it's critically important that we start to think of creating intelligent agents that are yours, that can learn and adapt the way that you learn and adapt. So you have artificial intelligence or intelligent agents that are kind of the new logic layer. Those replace the apps of today. You have a new immersive interfaces that replace the screens of today. And you have data that is structured in such a way that AI can understand us and we can understand their decision-making process. What you want is the benefit of these technologies, so where they're hyper-efficient, therefore sustainable, not the sort of massive data centers, but rather many, many billions of small agents at the edge that really make up the new web. What we want is a version of the future, which we need to start envisioning, that's not about the technology, but how that technology augments our capabilities. How does it make us smarter? We don't want to put autonomous agents into the world that will be 10 times more than the total number of humans operating every device in every environment, in our homes, in our schools, in our streets, in our bodies, without the ability to not just have deep learning, but to have deep understanding. A bunch of Congress people saying it's illegal, it's not gonna do anything. We need digital enforcement at the network layer, in the data itself. Global standards that are powering every device in this room, powering these lights, powering these microphones, they are the things that are the quiet infrastructure underneath that we all run on. We've been working with the IEEE, who standardized Wi-Fi and Ethernet and Bluetooth and things that we rely on today to enable a new global standard for data interoperability that enables spatial information, physical data from sensors, historical data to basically be fused together in any way, like Lego pieces, in a completely explicit and explainable model, much like we did for the World Wide Web, but now to allow the data to be combined, to be auditable, to be permissionable. And this is the kind of digital infrastructure fabric upon which we can enable then intelligence at the edge, enabling agents that are law-abiding, that can understand our ethics, our values. And so I think that this is the shift that we have to move towards. We have to think of this as a new global network, the third version of the web. And we need to build out that data infrastructure that enables all the benefits that we want in these smart cities of the future, where at the very least, all these smart things should work together. And that's the world that I see in the future.